he said, for reasserting himself, sir, whatever that might have meant. He talked a lot during the week, as plenty besides me can tell you. He'd taken a lot of trouble over his costume, and I believe he was going to speak to anyone he met on his way over, in the hopes of making them think he was the genuine article. He left the house a bit after 10.
He didn't say anything that led you to think he might be going to take his own life.
Oh, no, sir. I'm sure such a thought never went through his head.
He was sober?
Yes, sir. He hadn't touched a drink all day. As a matter of fact, he did say one very odd thing just as he was leaving. He turned back at the door and said to me, "Good night, Baines. I have an idea I may be going to my death."
What on earth did he mean by that?
I did ask him, sir, but he wouldn't say much. But I gathered he was afraid of some sort of trap.
Why should he be?
Well, sir, it's common knowledge that he hasn't been overly popular at the Abbey these last 2 years, and then this past week or two he's been going in and out pretty well as he pleased. It makes a man a bit suspicious.
Of what?
What it means.
He didn't consider remaining at home.
No, sir, though I did my best to urge him. I said it was running his head into a noose, but he said that whatever people could say about him, at least they shouldn't say he funked his fences, his expression, sir. Anyway, he'd been putting it around the neighbourhood for some days past that this was his chance. They'd been top dog long enough, but they wouldn't forget this night.
What did he mean by that?
Sir Ralph didn't confide his affairs to me, sir. The coroner looked angry. It was galling to be snubbed like that by such a witness.
You can add nothing that may be of assistance.
Only this, sir, and I don't know that it makes any difference, except perhaps it might throw a light on the way Sir Ralph was regarded up at the Abbey.